गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू रिमेनिंग टॉपिक्स इन मेकिंग इंडिपेंडेंट इंडियाज कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. सो टुडे टॉपिक इज द पार्लियामेंट्री सिस्टम. सो इंडिया अडॉप्टेड पार्लियामेंट्री सिस्टम ऑफ गवर्नमेंट. सो इंडिया अडॉप्टेड पार्लियामेंट्री सिस्टम ऑफ गवर्नमेंट बाय द ब्रिटिश कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. So within the parliamentary system there are two houses are there in the parliament. One is Lok Sabha, second one is the Rajya Sabha. So Lok Sabha is the more powerful compared to Rajya Sabha. Lok Sabha members directly elected by the people. So in India Lok Sabha members are the Member of Parliament. Member of Parliaments are more powerful compared to MLC, Member of Legislative Assembly. So, Rajya Sabha, another house is Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha members are 250 members in India. So, Lok Sabha members are 543 members in India. So within that the Lok Sabha is the more powerful. Why? Because Lok Sabha is more powerful because of the Lok Sabha members, means member of parliaments, were elected directly by the people. So according to the population they were provided the constituencies in each state. For example, in Andhra Pradesh, there are 25 MP seats are there. In Telangana there are 17 Lok Sabha seats are there. Uttar Pradesh having more MP seats in India. So according to the population, Uttar Pradesh is the highest populous country in the populated state in India. So that's why the Uttar Pradesh having more Lok Sabha seats in India. So like that, according to the population they were provided the MP seats. So Lok Sabha members were directly elected. That's why the Lok Sabha is the more powerful in the parliament. So the parliamentary system of government. Within the parliamentary system of government, parliament having more powers and making legislature and have right to implement executive. So the leader of the Lok Sabha is the Prime Minister. The Prime Minister was appointed by the majority of the MPs and he was the leader of the house. After that, the Prime Minister was appointed cabinet ministers, including the cabinet ministers, the Prime Minister and other ministers, cabinet ministers we have called as the government. The government have rights to make the legislature, make right to make the laws for our country. So the head of the parliament, who was the head of the parliament, means the president was actually president was the head of the parliament, head of the country. The president is the first citizen of our country. But in India, the president was head of the country, head of the union. As well as in America also the president was the head of the union. But in India, the president not having more powers, he was a ceremonial device. He was functioning according to the guidelines of the ministers. Why? Because the ministers were elected by the people. So the ministers are the having more powers. Why? Because they are the representatives of the people. So that's why the president was indirectly elected in India. So when we compare to American Indian constitution is the Indian government is the president, parliamentary system of government. In American government system is the presidential system. In American government is presidential system. President have more powers. President directly elected by the people in America. That's why the president having more powers. President is the head of the country, the first citizen of America. He has more powers in America according to the American Constitution. So America was following the presidential system of presidential system. So within the presidential system, the president was directly appointed by the people. That's why he has more powers. He make the laws and he implement the laws. He was directly appointed to the ministers. So in America, the ministers are called as the secretaries. The president have right to withdraw their ministers without any intimation. He has powers anytime the president have right to remove his ministers, and he has right to remove his secretaries. So in America, the ministers are called as the secretaries. So the president have right to remove his secretaries in any time. So in India, that is the difference. The president is the head of the all departments, head of the all departments. But he has not have to take decisions. He was depended on by the prime minister and ministers. So he has not right to remove any ministers. Except the ministers are having the majority in the Lok Sabha. Motion, he has the confidence. So the ministers have the confidence in the parliament. So they have to rule the country. So the ministers were not removed by the president. The minister except the ministers having so confidence in the house. Whenever the ministers having confidence in the house, in the Lok Sabha, they have not removed. They have not removed by the president. So the ministers having confidence in the house, in the Lok Sabha, when president not have right to remove them from the parliament. So the president, like in India, the president having the nominal rights. They are not having more powers in India. The president was a ceremonial device. President has the less rights in India compared to America. In America, the all powers are exist in the president. President having all powers in America. So like this is the two types of systems when we are compared to India and America. So in India, the president are not having more powers. In America, president have more powers. He was appointed his secretaries, and also he has right to make legislature, and also he has right to implement executive. So but in India, the parliamentary system of government, so parliament has more powers. Parliament making laws, parliament implement the laws, executive powers. Parliament have executive powers. So similarity is, the head of the country is the president, the first citizen of the country, president. He was the head of the all departments. In India also, the president is the head of all departments, head of the government. The president is the head of the government. Similarly, in America, the head of the the president is the head of the all departments. He was the head of the country, first citizen of the country. So, but in America, the president only making legislature, and he has executive powers. So that is the difference between India and America about the parliamentary system of government. So now we are going to the federalism. So in the world, there are two types of federal constitutions we have found. In the world, the importantly, the principal constitutions are two types. One is the unitary system, and the second one is federal constitution. So unitary constitution and federal constitution. So unitary constitution, supremacy of the central polity. So unitary constitution, the central government, only one government was formed, and that government, union government, has all the powers in the unitary constitution. In the unitary constitution, only one government was formed, the central union government has all powers. There is no other subsidiary governments, there is no other subsidiary sovereign politics, there is no other subsidiary sovereign politics. Only one government, the central government, union government, it has all powers in the unitary constitution. Now federal constitution, within the federal constitution, there is the dual polity. We have found dual polity. So central government or union government, at the same time, we have found the state governments. So subsidiary sovereign politics, we have found subsidiary sovereign politics in federal constitution. For example, in India, central government functioning, at the same time state governments also functioning. So the two are having their own sovereign politics, sovereign rights. According to the constitution was provide the rights for central government as well as the state governments. So according to the constitution, they are functioning. So like dual polity, we have found dual polity, central government as the state as well as state governments, parallelly they are functioning within the country, is called as the federal constitution. So India has adopted federal constitution, as well as America is also adopted federal constitution. So we are having the America is also federal governments, they are functioning in India also, the federal governments are functioning. So two governments have their own sovereign rights according to the constitution. Federation means establishment of dual polity, state governments as well as the central government functioning parallelly, functioning together within the country. So India draft constitution is federal constitution, is called dual polity. Indian constitution is the federal constitution. Indian dual polity is similar to the American constitution. Federal constitution is similar to the American constitution. In America, central government is called as federal government. In America, the central government is called as the federal government. In India, the central government is called as union government. In America, state governments are the state governments. In India, state governments are state governments. So in America, central government is called as the federal government. So in India, central government is called as the union government. In America, state governments are the state governments. In India, state governments are the state governments. So under the American constitution, in federal constitution, is not a league of the state. Under the American constitution, central government is not the league of the state government, league of the states. Central government is not the league of the states. Okay, central government is not the league of the states. The central government is separate and the state governments are separate. Central government are functioning there according to the constitution, according to their rights, they are functioning. State governments are functioning there according to their rights. So like that, the two are different. So the under the American constitution, the federal government is not the league of the states. Federal government is not the league of the states, as well as in India also. Under the Indian constitution, so central government The union government is not the league of the states. It's not the league of the states. So they are separate. So state governments are separate. Central governments are separate. So the state administrative units or agencies are not the federal government. The state administrative units or agencies are not the federal government. So in America, the state administrative units or agencies are not the part or not the federal government. So in India also, the state governments, the state administration, state administrative units or agencies are not the union government, are not the union government. These two are totally different. In the same way, Indian Union government is not league of the states. Indian government is also, union government is also not league of the states. And also state administration and agencies are not the union government, are not come under the union government. The similarities between the India and America has come to an end. So the, now we will see the proposed Indian constitution is a dual polity with a single citizenship. But dual polity with single citizenship. India is followed the single citizenship. So the for whole country, so all state people, for whole country, every citizen, all citizens are having, they are having only a single citizenship in India. But in America, they are followed the dual citizenship. They are followed the dual citizenship. There is only one citizenship for the whole country. There is no state citizenships in India. There is no state citizenship in India. India have federation, and at the same time, India has uniformity in all basic matters. India is the federation. India is follow certainly. India is the follow the federal federation. At the same time, we are making integrity. We want to make the integrity, and they want to make the uniformity for whole country. They are followed some methods. So three methods adopted by the draft constitution for unity. Three methods adopted by the draft constitution for unity. The three methods are single judiciary, uniformity in fundamental laws, single judiciary, uniformity in fundamental laws, civil and criminal laws, a common all India civil services, a common all India civil services. Like three methods were proposed for unity of the country. Those are single judiciary, single judiciary, common civil and criminal laws, common civil and criminal laws, and common all India civil services, uniformity in criminal and criminal civil laws, uniformity in criminal and civil laws, a common all India services, a common all India services. So first we will see about the dual judiciary, duality of legal courts and the duality of civil services. Dual judiciary. So for federal constitution, federal in America, they followed the dual judiciary. In most of the federal constitution, federal countries, they follow the dual judiciary. Dual judiciary means the central judiciary is different and the state judiciary is different. So central judiciary followed the criminal and civil laws separate civil and criminal laws. In the state judiciary has followed their own civil and criminal laws. Like the civil procedure courts, criminal procedure courts, penal courts, civil procedure courts, criminal procedure courts, penal courts are different in between the central judiciary as well as state judiciary. So the central judiciary was not involved in the matters of the state judiciary. So the state judiciary is the final authority. So the everyone have to obey the judgments of the state judiciary. So they cannot go to the higher courts. They not have right to go to higher courts. Like the dual, in the dual judiciary was functioning in America. So they in America. So the high courts are the final authority when we are going to the high courts, high court judges are giving judgments, are the final judgments. So we cannot, the Supreme Court not hear the appeals against the lower courts. So the high courts and the Supreme Courts form one single integrated judiciary. But in India, we are following single judiciary. In India, we are following single judiciary. High court and the Supreme Courts form one single integrated judiciary. High courts and Supreme Courts come under the single integrated judiciary. So Canada is the only country it is which is the close parallel to Indian judiciary. Canada is the country parallel to Indian judiciary. So the Australia is not similar to Indian judiciary. So the Australia approximately it will, but Australia is not similar to Indian judiciary. Canada is only country which is the close to parallel to Indian judiciary. So in the same, in some federal countries, the Supreme Court cannot overrule the judgments of the state courts. So in some federal courts, like in America, federal countries, Supreme Court cannot overrule the judgments of the state courts, but in India, the Supreme Court overrule the judgments of the state courts. But in India, the Supreme Court can hear appeals against the decision of any government and give his own judgment. So Supreme Court is the having high powers in India. The Supreme Court judgment is the final judgment. So Supreme Court can hear appeals against the decision of any court and give his own judgment. So caretaking to eliminate all diversity of laws. So the great courts of civil and criminal laws, such as for equal, similar enough for whole country. So the great courts of civil and criminal laws, such as civil procedure court, criminal procedure courts, panel courts, are equal for all country, equal for whole country. So like another acts like Evidence Act, Transfer of Property, Evidence Act, Transfer of Property Act, and the laws of marriage, divorce laws, inheritance, laws of marriage, so divorce laws, inheritance, Transfer of Property Act. So these all are similar, these acts all are similar for whole country in India, so that the uniformity can always be preserved without weaken the federal system. So uniformity can always be preserved without weaken the federal system. So in legislature, now we are going to legislature. So legislature laws can be divided into three types in India. In a legislature was divided into three types in India. One is a state list, central list, and concurrent list. In the state list, state governments have powers to make the laws and implement the laws. In the central list, central governments only have right to make the laws and implement the laws. So concurrent list, within the concurrent list, both central government, state government have right to make the laws, but central government has more powers in concurrent list. So if contradictory means the conflicts which arises in between the state government and the central government at the same time, at the time for making the laws in concurrent list, the central government laws are valid. In the concurrent list. So like there are three lists come under the constitution. So the central list, state list, and concurrent list in India. So according to that, they have make the laws and implement laws in India. In case where the state, so the dual polity which in the federal system followed implemented the dual services, the dual polity. So in America, they are following the dual federal system, federal constitution, dual polity. So where in the federal system they are also implement the dual services. They are also implemented the dual services. According to their requirements, they appoint the employees, the white collar jobs. But in federal system, the central government as well as the state governments, they have their own the civil services. They conduct the separate civil services, and they appointed their white collar jobs for according to their requirements. So like dual services, implemented dual services in all federations. There is a federal civil services and a state civil services. Federal civil services in America, federal government, the federal conduct the federal civil service, means for central they conduct the federal civil service. In the state wide, the state governments are conduct the state civil service, and they appoint their according to their requirement, they appoint their employees. So the in India, the federation have a dual service, but with one exemption. But in India, dual services. So state governments are also appointed their employees, like in example in Andhra Pradesh, APS, Andhra Pradesh Civil Services. Andhra Pradesh government conduct the civil services, and they appoint their employees like RDO, MRO, revenue inspector, like that. They appoint their employees. So central government in central level, all India civil services. But the central level, all India Union Service, UPSC, Union Public Service Commission, UPSC, Union Public Service Commission conduct the exams for whole country. So they appoint IAS, IPS, IAF, employees for whole country. They appointed the same qualification. They provide the same qualifications for whole country. People of any state can have right to the civil service UPSC exams. So like they maintain the unity of the country by the All India Civil Service exams, by the All India Civil Service exams. So with their similar qualification, similar salaries, and similar training provide to all candidates who are selected from the civil services, All India Civil Services. Like they make the unity, and they shows the equality in between the people by the All India Civil Service exams. So the constitution provide that without depriving the state rights, the central government was the central level organization, the independent organization, that is UPSC, All India Public Service Commission. All India Public Service Commission was conduct the civil service exams, and appointed IAS, IPS, IAF officers for whole country. So they provide the employees to the state governments also. So with uniform scale of payment, and the members which appointed to the strategic posts throughout the India by the Public Service Commission, IAS, IPS officers are recruited for both central and state governments. So thank you all of you.